Hello student, another module for this week, module 21, it is about your Balantidium coli. A few reminders before you start watching the video lecture. Number one, please take down notes. A soft copy of this presentation has been added into your smart kits. Second is listen attentively, avoid unnecessary distraction. And third, give extra attention to info mark with a star. Here are your learning objectives for today. Okay, so we are now done with the flagellates, which is yung sila trichomonas, sila diatomeba. So, today you will have now your ciliate. And there is only one ciliate that is capable of infecting men. So, sa dami ng ciliates, isa lang po talaga ang kaya mag-infect sa humans, which is your Balantidium coli. This Balantidium coli is the largest protozoan infecting men. I repeat, Balantidium coli is the largest protozoan infecting man. So, sa lahat ng protozoa, such as your amoeba, flagellates, ciliates, etc., pinakamalaki po, again, si Balantidium coli. Again, this is the only ciliate capable of infecting man. For the route of transmission, man gets infection through ingestion of food and water contaminated with Balantidium coli cyst. So, basically, no, kung napapansin nyo, yung mga protozoas natin, commonly, nakukuha talaga siya sa ingestion ng contaminated food or water. Kasi, di ba, kung natatandaan nyo, isa sa general characteristic ng mga protozoa natin is gusto nila yung mga moist environment or yung may mga tubig. So, yun. That's the reason why most of them can be acquired actually nga through contaminated food and especially water. Especially yung cyst form. Kapag may trophozoite cyst, si cyst ang infective stage. So, pag nakain nyo si cyst, pwede kayong ma-infect ng mga protozoan such as your Balantidium coli. This can cause ulcer formation on the intestine leading to bloody diarrhea. Kasi nagkakaroon ng ulcerations in the intestine, so magmamanifest yan sa stool natin at it can potentially cause bloody diarrhea nga. Okay, so for the morphology naman, it is very good thing to take note of na i-differentiate natin ang trophozoite versus the cyst form of the Balantidium coli. For the trophozoite form, it contains a cytostome. So, here is your cytostome. So, parang punit siya, ganon. Which is through which the ciliate acquires food. So, in this cytostome of our Balantidium coli, dito po papasok yung food niya. So, di ba, parang bibig siya, kumbaga. Yun yung cytostome ng trophozoite form ng ating Balantidium coli. And trophozoite also has a cytopage naman. This is the cytopage. And this cytopage through which the ciliate excretes its waste. So, kumbaga, itong cytopage, ito yung parang puwet ng ating Balantidium coli. Dito lumalabas yung waste materials ng ating trophozoite ng Balantidium. So again, yung trophozoite form may cytostome wherein dito siya nag-a-acquire ng food. So ito yung parang bibig niya. And yung cytopage, dito lalabas yung waste material. So parang puwet nga kung sa tao. And for the cyst form naman of our Balantidium coli, it is good thing to take note of that the cyst is double-walled. Yan, dalawa yung wall niya. And it is refractile. So, under the microscope, makikita nyo yung parang refractile characteristic ng ating cyst ng Balantidium coli. For the both trophozoite and cyst naman, both trophozoite and cyst, it possesses a kidney bean-shaped macronucleus and a dot-like micronucleus. Again, ulitin natin. Both the trophozoite, so si trophozoite and cyst form of the Balantidium coli, possesses a kidney bean-shaped macronucleus. Ma'am, nasan yan? This one. Macro, meaning malaki. Malaking nucleus. Macronucleus, makang kidney bean. Ayan, di ba? Mukha siyang kidneys. This is the trophozoite form macronucleus. Di ba? Mukhang kidney bean. And a dot-like micronucleus. Micronucleus po, this one. Nucleus din siya, pero dot. Parang dot lang. So, micronucleus, dot-like. Then this is the micronucleus of your trophozoid form. So basically, no, trophozoid and cyst again contains or possesses a kidney bean shape macronucleus and a dot like micronucleus. Please take note, that is a recall question in the board exam. Again, ulitin natin, recall question po. Balantidium coli, trophozoid and cyst is characterized by a kidney bean shape macronucleus, this one and this one, and a dot like, ito po, that like micronucleus. Both of them contains that characteristic. And when it comes to the life cycle, although it is mentioned that this Balantidium coli can be actually acquired through the ingestion of contaminated food or water, however, there is a prevalence associated with poor environmental sanitation, and 25% daw po of human cases, which is somehow, guys, malaki na po yung 25%, and it shows some associated with exposure to pig or swine. So, ayan, commonly daw, 25% ng reported cases is yung taong daw yun nagkaroon ng exposure sa pigs natin. For the diagnosis naman, stool examination will reveal the cyst or trophozoid form. So, basically, either of those pwedeng diagnostic stage. For the prevention and control naman, the method of prevention and control are essentially the same as that of amoebiasis since they can be acquired through the same route of transmission. An additional measure is to prevent contaminating the food and water with fecal material. And for the treatment naman, the drug of choice is tetracycline or metronidazole. And if you have any more questions or clarifications, you may contact me in this email.